I'm good. How about you?
Good, thank you.
No problem. For the people who don't know who you are, how would you explain Lady Gaga to them?
I am a do-it-yourself pop star.
And Just Dance. I feel like it should be like the hit of the summer. It needs to be the hit of the summer. What was your inspiration for Just Dance?
The party scene in New York. Yeah, just like, but more specifically, the party scene of where I lived, and like the lifestyle and the fashion and like the fame of like the culture down there.
Yeah. The album is called The Fame, correct?
Yeah, it's like all about the lifestyle and that inner sense of fame that, you know, you don't need to be a celebrity or be rich to have. It's just like something inside of you.
Sounds awesome. And that's coming out soon, right?
Yeah, the album is coming out in Canada in like a month.
Oh.
Less than a month. And then it's also coming out in Germany at the same time. And then it won't come out in the U.S. until October.
Oh, so it's going to be a while.
I know, but it's going to be good because by the time you can buy it, you know, everyone will know about more of the songs on the album. I really don't want to drop the album based on just one single. You know, I want people to... We're not going to, like, do a second single before the album release, but I want people to know about me as an artist and as a writer so that, you know, they want the album as a piece of work, not just because they like the single.
True. That's actually a better way to go about it. Do you actually know what you want the second single to be?
I mean, I know what I want to be the second single, but I don't want to say it yet.
Oh, okay. So, your style, it's very different from what everyone else is kind of doing right now. Like, what work? How do you come up with all these ideas? It just comes to you?
Well, I mean... Like, the house and I, like, we're all, like, really close, and I have, my best friend who's in the house, he is, like, my creative partner, and he's a designer, and we design the clothes together, and we do, like, a lot of research, you know, we go to museums, we surf the internet, we look at, like, European designers on YouTube, and look in magazines. I like to really, focus more on European trends and how to incorporate them, mostly because they're so much more ahead of the United States in terms of fashion.
Yeah, I totally agree. I completely agree.
So we focus on that stuff, and then, you know, we kind of piece different references together. And it's always funny to me, like, when I did Miss Universe, some of the comments on YouTube, they're like, what is she wearing? Like, she's crazy. She looks so weird. And it's funny to me because I know that, like, the shape of the jacket is inspired by, like, one of the most respected designers in Italy.
Yeah.
I'm just like, they don't know yet, but they'll know.
I thought you looked perfectly fine.
What?
I thought you looked great. You were awesome there.
I'm not saying people don't like it. Everybody, you know, is so fond of really, responded well to the visuals, but I kind of love and feed off of, oh my God, I love her, she's awesome, but she's a little weird. Like, there's something about that I really like, because it means I'm challenging people.
Yeah. So how was Miss Universe? Was that like a big thing for you?
Yeah, it was really big. I mean, it was kind of ridiculous that I was even there. At the time, I was, you know, doing well in Canada, but I'm relatively, like, unknown, you know?
Yeah.
And that performance really, like, so now the world knows who I am, so it was a really big deal for me, and I appreciated that the choreographer, like, really took a chance on really pushing me with the network, I didn't know him beforehand, but he was a really big fan. So when the Pussycat Dolls couldn't do the performance, the choreographer for the show was like, "We've got to get Lady Gaga. She's like the future, and if you want something cutting edge, like she's the person to get." And they did it. So it was really amazing, and that's such a pristine environment.
Yeah.
And I come from such an unpristine background that it was like so interesting, and it was fun. And honestly, just to be in Vietnam in such a political place on like the first broadcast of the war, that was like insanity. And
Yeah.
a billion people were watching, so.
Yeah, and I realized too, like, after that performance, that on iTunes your single went, like, way up on the charts and stuff.
It went crazy, like really crazy. But I have to say, like, I mean, I asked around and stuff, at the label about, what television performances really do for songs.
Yeah.
And they said that, it usually does something, but that the song really is like a bullet. I mean, it really stands on its own 2 feet, and I feel like it's a whole like thing in itself, if that makes any sense. Like it went up in sales like over 300% on iTunes, which is like ridiculous.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's great too.
Yeah, it's fun. Well, I'm just glad that people like the song,
Yeah, they
They
should.
did a good job at writing it.
Yeah, so are you gonna do like radio promo and stuff to get it on the radio and stuff?
Oh yeah. Well, I'm going out. It's already like a hit on dance radio, so now I want it to cross over in America. So I'm like gonna be going to all of the radio stations
Awesome.
and performing and just doing another round in America. And I'm really happy. Like MTV started playing the video in Europe, so that's gonna be pretty big overseas too.
Yeah, I needs to be like a worldwide hit.
I know. I really think it can, and I just can't believe most of the time the whole world doesn't go at once, And right now, like everything's happening everywhere at the same time, and it's just like wow.
Yeah, it's great. I can't wait. NYU, I want to talk about NYU. So you left NYU?
Yeah, I was only there for a year. I got accepted to Tisch.
And did you just not like it, or?
And that's why I was like kind of lame, I guess. But there really wasn't. I didn't like. I mean, and that's coming from somebody that's been studying theater in New York since I was like 11, and like being on the circuit. So living in like that kind of environment for me ended up being like more unhealthy than it was healthy, because I felt like it was really like stifling my creativity because they wanted everybody to be the same.
Yeah.
Kind of thing, like they were honing everybody's skills in a very like conventional way.
I wouldn't even want that.
Yeah, it was just like strange. And like I mean, you see from my show, I'm more of a performance artist, and I have a very specific way that I like to be, or
Yeah.
that I am rather. And I just felt like it was kind of an unrealistic way of looking at art, except for the acting teachers that I had. I had some really great acting teachers. Like Larry was really brilliant there. He really helped me. But I would go on theater auditions for musicals, and they would say, "You're too pop." And then I would be in a nightclub, and I'd hear that, Columbia Records had come out to see me, and they'd say, "She's too theater." So I was sort of in this like place of
Like stuck in the
not
middle.
really fitting in anywhere, and so I decided to just kind of, okay, if I don't fit in anywhere, how about I just not fit and make that cool?
Awesome.